8th of March 2020, very windy and raining day today. Sofia restaurant has a new renovation. Hi, Greg Rose.
Hello.
Hi, how are you? Thank you for interview. And can you introduce your name?
Yes, I'm Rosemary.
And I'm Greg.
Okay, and when did you start teaching tango?
Well, we started at first in 2005, working for a large Latin school where tango was one of the many dance styles offered. And then in 2010, we decided to go and just teach tango only.
In the beginning, Rosemary was teaching and I wasn't teaching. And then on one day I came along to pick her up and there were two classes, but for the second class there was no teacher. So Rosemary said, would you mind teaching that class? And so that was, I didn't know to start teaching maybe for a couple of years after Rosemary.
Great happening.
So my third, that was my first class. I just turned up and taught the class.
Okay, and then your philosophy about teaching tango?
The philosophy.
Well, we.
Your passion, aim to teaching?
Our passion is about having people enjoy themselves, dancing.
Lovely.
Not just one style of tango, but everything from traditional milonguero, close embrace, open embrace, nuevo. We like to give them all of those skills, so it doesn't matter where they go, they will have the skills
to enjoy
their tango.
Okay, and who is your favorite dancer in Buenos Aires?
The one that we've had the best classes is with Gustavo Rivera. Gustavo Rivera is the teacher of teachers. When you go along to his classes, there can be 100 people in the class. He was running classes in the paper factory in Buenos Aires. And you'd go along and there'd be a class from about 9 o'clock until midnight.
Oh my God.
And there was easily 100 people there. And out of those 100 people, there were lots and lots of teachers. And the teachers were there because they wanted to get material and understand more about tango so they could then travel the world and teach. And then there were lots of students as well. he often referred to the classes as deep fundamentals. So you needed really good fundamentals, but they were quite difficult classes. He would teach a long sequence and you had to try to get the sequence and then get all the fundamentals to be able to dance and then get the musicality. So really, he's the teacher of teachers. But there's others when...
We invite teachers to our house to Brisbane.
We invite
teachers every year to visit us. And of course, we wouldn't invite them unless we thought they were really good. So it varies. Sometimes we will have a couple of teachers a year, but we have had up to 4 or 5 sets of teachers, depending on what their travel dates are and when they're touring. So all of our guest teachers we include in our list of friends and also teachers that we admire and we think have something really important to contribute to our Brisbane community. So we also try to get different sorts of teachers
that
Brisbane will benefit from a variety of perspectives and approaches.
Okay, and if someone visit Queensland Milonga, they will wonder why 3 songs in one tanda. So, good explanation for first visit Queensland Milonga?
In the beginning, when people were DJing here in Brisbane, they'd follow the recipe of Buenos Aires, which was quite often 4 songs for tango, 3 for valse, and 3 for Milonga. Then after a while, particularly on special occasions, there were always more women than men. And so the women were saying, if it's 4 songs, that's a long time to sit out. And let's say I've got to sit out for 2 tandas, that's a really long time. So the idea is that everybody started to cut to 3 songs so that the men could ask a lot more women. So each woman would get more dances. And if they did sit out, it would be a little bit shorter than normal. So that's really how it's come about. First of all, at the special events, but now everybody does it.
That's good news for all leaders who visit here.
Well, the leaders can be quite busy because they're going from lady to lady to make sure that everybody gets a dance. Milonga, from here today, for example, I'll play 3 song tandas. The last 3 tandas of tango will be 4 songs, and everybody knows get your favourite dancer for the last 3 tandas because it's 4 songs.
It's an extra bonus track.
Alright. Okay, thank you for interview today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
Say hello to overseas dancers.
Hi guys.
Hi.
We're in Brisbane, we're friendly.
Do come along to Love Street in Brisbane.
And your name and where are you from?
My name is Amanda Rosenfeld. I'm originally from Cairns, far north Queensland, but I've been living in Brisbane for 30 years. And I started dancing tango roughly 4 years ago, and I came into dancing through my lovely, lovely partner Greg Nelson. And it's been a really, really nice journey.
Thank you, and then you recommend Milonga in Brisbane 203?
Street Milonga, I'd highly recommend. Also the Wellers Hill Milonga. And the Divine Milonga is also really lovely.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.